In this video, I discuss what the Star Wars equivalent of the Snyder Cut is. Also, only 19.3% of my viewers are subscribed to this channel, so don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. The short answer to the question of this video is that no, there is no Snyder Cut equivalent of the Star Wars franchise. Zack Snyder left his project of Justice League due to a family tragedy, and the subsequent movie that followed was nothing like his original vision. As far as we know, none of the creators that have left Star Wars projects recently left because of family tragedies. In all honesty, they were probably just all fired because they weren't on the same page as Kathleen Kennedy. So from that aspect of the Zack Snyder situation, there is no Snyder Cut equivalent of the Star Wars franchise. Now, when it comes to stories that were changed a lot from when they were originally conceived, there are a decent amount of projects that we can talk about. I'm gonna discuss numerous Star Wars cuts that are either nothing like the Snyder Cut situation, or fairly similar to the Snyder Cut situation. But again, nothing is exactly like the Zack Snyder situation. The first cut that people have mentioned is the JJ cut. Now, if you've never heard of this before, that's probably good because this is easily the dumbest one on the list. The JJ cut originated from rumors that circulated before The Rise of Skywalker came out that Disney was trying really hard to change JJ's vision of The Rise of Skywalker. Is there a whole cut of the movie that is drastically different than the one we got? No. However, based off of the novelization of The Rise of Skywalker, there are a lot of deleted scenes that are in the book but not in the movie, so there's definitely a lot of lost footage that wasn't in the movie that we saw. Another thing, if you notice from the behind the scenes material of The Rise of Skywalker, there are no public deleted scenes for us to watch. This usually means that the movie had a really troubled production. If you look at Rogue One, it also has no public deleted scenes. Now, I really do want to see those deleted scenes to see if it would have made the movie any better. But there is no JJ cut of the film that is drastically different than the one we got. I take back what I said earlier. This next one is actually by far the dumbest one on the list. The next cut on the list is the George Lucas cut. Now, what on earth is the George Lucas cut? The George Lucas cut refers to the rumor that there was a George Lucas cut of The Rise of Skywalker, and that it is currently shelved somewhere in Lucasfilm. Now, the reason this rumored cut exists is because there are people dumb enough on the internet to believe other YouTubers who clearly lie all the time and spread incredibly false rumors. I'm not kidding, there are many YouTubers who go on YouTube and spread lies constantly, and people still believe it, even after these lies have been proven to be lies. And the George Lucas cut is one of those lies. So in short, no, there is no George Lucas cut of The Rise of Skywalker. Now we actually move on to the reasonable cuts on this list. Up next, we have Star Wars Duel of the Fates, also known as the Colin Trevorrow cut. Now, unlike the last two, this cut has a lot of truth to it. A man named Colin Trevorrow was originally hired to direct Star Wars Episode 9, and he was inevitably fired in 2017 before he could film any part of his movie, and he was replaced by J.J. Abrams, who made the well-known Rise of Skywalker. Colin Trevorrow's Episode 9 was titled Duel of the Fates, named after the incredible music that plays during the Darth Maul fight in The Phantom Menace. Sometime in early 2020, an early draft of Duel of the Fates was leaked to the public, and it was revealed that Colin Trevorrow's Duel of the Fates was drastically different than J.J. Abrams' The Rise of Skywalker. So this is similar to the Snyder Cut in the sense that there exists an original story out there that is drastically different than the story that we got. The main difference between the Snyder Cut and Duel of the Fates is that there isn't a single second of Duel of the Fates that exists. With the Snyder Cut, Zack Snyder filmed that entire movie, it's just it was reshot, and the original footage that was made was never edited properly. We did get some concept art from Duel of the Fates, which was kinda cool, but when it comes to visuals, that is all we have. People have been clamoring for like an animated version of Duel of Fates, and while I would love that, there is no way that's ever gonna happen. But there is currently a fan project going on right now where it's a comic adaptation of Duel of the Fates. Links in the description, you guys should definitely check it out if you're interested. But if Lucasfilm were to somehow make a version of Duel of the Fates like an animated movie, then I guess it would be relatively close to what the Snyder Cut is. But I would say the closest thing that exists to the Snyder Cut is the Lord and Miller cut of Solo. For those of you who didn't know, Phil Lord and Chris Miller were originally tasked to direct Solo, and they directed about 90% of the movie. They filmed a lot of it. However, they weren't on the same page as Kathleen Kennedy, and they were fired, and Kathleen got Ron Howard to reshoot pretty much the whole movie into the Solo we know today. The big difference between the Lord and Miller cut and the Colin Trevorrow cut of Duel of the Fates is that the Lord and Miller cut of Solo has a lot of footage to it, Lord & Miller filmed a lot of that movie, and currently somewhere in Lucasfilm, there is a lot of that footage that exists. If Lucasfilm really wanted to, they could patch up all the footage that Lord & Miller filmed and release it as a presentable movie. Now, I would love for this to happen because, for one, I'm not the biggest fan of Solo, and two, I love pretty much all of the work that Lord & Miller have done. Besides the situation of Zack Snyder leaving and the reason why Lord & Miller were fired, the biggest difference between the two projects is that there exists a fan movement that is in support of the Solo film we got. When it comes to Justice League, almost everyone hates the theatrical version of that movie, but with Solo, there is a cult following of that movie. The hashtag Make Solo 2 Happen movement started by people who loved the current version of Solo. So since there is no movement to try and get the original version of Solo released, it is very different to the Snyder Cut in that respect. Again, with the hashtag Make Solo 2 Happen movement, there is no way they're ever going to release a completed version of the Lord & Miller cut. And those are all the potential cuts in the Star Wars franchise that somewhat resemble the Snyder Cut. Thank you everyone so much for watching another one of my videos. If you want to see more from me, I have two videos right here that you guys can go check out. I hope everyone has a wonderful day. Don't forget Genetic Law Squad, and I will see you guys next time.